hit the ignition and beat the emission. Like a clinician more than a musician. My flow rare like a first edition. Report for dismission. Everything I ever thought of, it came to fruition. King of the transition. We never switch and peep the acquisition, no omission. Your lyrics drier than the prior and the prepare for collision. Then the satellite that's on an orbiting mission.
We're looking live at a beautiful fly-in to Everbank Field in Jacksonville. But even if you closed your eyes, Brock, you'd still know exactly where you were by the rallying cry of the Jaguar faithful in the stands. Ball teed up, Logan Cook after the kick. And we're underway from Everbank Stadium. Ty Chandler to return. It's an excellent return, but he gets popped at the end of it.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 36-yard line.
So their offense out now to get this game started. It's first and 10. Chandler again. And they bring him down after he ran through him up to the 43. Call it 7 yards, and now they'll have second down and 3.
That's a run that you'll take the result in the NFL every time. A nice play, a solid gain, but it's also a run that you know and you may come back to. Because if you were that close to breaking off an explosive one, you really break the backs of a defense.
Operating from the gun, it's McCarthy. Pass is caught, it's TJ Hawkinson. And he stopped cold at the spot. Ooh, he paid for that one, but hey, still enough for that first down.
I'm sure coach, a play caller doesn't mind making the job a little bit easier. You know, play calling's a lot simpler and easier when you count on the offense to move the chains on those early downs.
Give up the gut to Chandler. And he sneaks this through the middle, maybe a gain of 2.
Hey, we know running the ball in the NFL is hard, and that play pretty indicative of it. Here's the key, though. At the end of the game, those type of plays got to be in the minority, and the majority have got to do some damage.
8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. From the shotgun, McCarthy. Grabbed by Jordan Addison. And he's able to drive this to the 29 before the stop. It's a 21-yard gain. And that's going to give the Vikings the first down. McCarthy looking to throw. And they get this all the way down to the 16-yard line. A very productive play from the rookie QB out of Michigan. That gets them a first down.
That is what elite offenses are all about. Why worry about 3 downs when you need only 1? Move the chains in 1 play and keep driving that defense backwards.
All set up now for 1st and 10. From the red zone now. Forces that one and it's intercepted. That is Lewis Seen. And the Jaguars, they're going to have it. And he's going to hang on to that football. That's his first career interception. Inside the red zone, they could feel how tight they were to the goal line. And then bam, Brock, they're off the field after a clutch interception.
I tell you what, football's the ultimate team game. But this is a situation where an individual picks up all 10 of his guys out there on the field. Somebody else is going to pick up the tab at dinner tonight for him.
Here's ETN to begin the drive. And he's going to be brought down up at the 28-yard line. He finds him 16 yards and a new set of downs.
You know, Kate, if you notice those guys that love to feed themselves on the field, right? They love to just get more and more. They're hungry for even more. I'll tell you what, that tackle, it prevented something that's going to be a lot bigger, but that back remains hungry.
Tight end reels in the shallow throw, and he's up to the 35-yard line as they reel him in.
He's just one of those guys, Kate. Even when he's not open, he's still a target thanks to that physicality and his ability to just play bully ball. They don't like forcing into coverage, but sometimes when you got a bully like him that can create space, just find a way to get him the ball.
They get six and a first down as well.
Well, looky here. You don't even have to worry now about a third down call as that run moves the sticks. Now that call you had ready, though, you can recycle it. Save it for later for that next third down coming.
He's on the move. He's going to keep it this time. And what a hit there. Alex, she faced the price for moving the chains that time.
You know, these are the type of plays that really get an offense going. This is a chance for QB to inspire the guys around him, calling his own number, carrying his teammates to a first down on that big run. That inflates an offense, and it can suck the wind out of that defense.
Took off with it again. Big gainer here as he picks up 20. And that'll be good for a Jacksonville first down.
Oh, that just sucks the wind out of a defense. So demoralizing. So many guys do things the right way, only to see a quarterback evade the pressure and go get that first down anyway.
Chased out to his right. Ooh, he got hit as he was throwing, and unsurprisingly, it falls incomplete. Second down coming up.
Well, that's one you chalk up to the pressure earning that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target, hit him, altered that last second attempt to get rid of him.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. From the shotgun, Lawrence escapes the pocket. And the Vikings rush brings him down. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up.
All right, first sack on the board on the first drive as a defense. And now, well, now we let the chess match begin. The adjustments begin because we know pressure leads to sacks. And sacks in this league often leads to wins.
Reeled in at the seven. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal. Working inside the red zone. And there's a man there. It's intercepted. And the Vikings get the football as he makes his third interception of this season. Well, they were thinking at least a field goal on the drive if they couldn't reach the end zone, right? But the interception keeps them from even getting three out of this possession.
You really hope at the end of this game you don't look back and go, shoulda, woulda, coulda. If we could have gotten some points out of that drive early, we wouldn't be in the situation we are in now.
And they bring him down up at the 12-yard line. So that was an exciting first quarter, but not the cleanest. A couple of early turnovers. A couple of zeros on the board right now. We're ready now for the second quarter to begin. Vikings in control of it. They're looking at second and pretty short. From the shotgun, McCarthy. Tried to connect, but it winds up incomplete. First time this game they've looked to him. And what will they dial up on third and short? Now it's McCarthy. Complete beyond the marker. And he's brought down after a nice gain and a first down. Looking to throw, McCarthy. And no look there, that throw falls to the ground.
Those passes get more and more difficult as you try to get aggressive downfield. I love the call. I love pushing the ball down the field. But the windows in the throwing lanes aren't there long. And it only takes a little bit for a throw to be off.
Into the hands of Jefferson, complete. And he'll get it up to the 44. They'll come up first and 10. Shotgun handoff now to Chandler. And they crush him right near the marker. Looks close, but yep, Brock, I think he safely got that first down before the hit.
Kate, don't think for a second this is time you step off the gas. You can feel this defense right there on their heels. And now is the best chance to go push the envelope and get aggressive.
On the move, headed right. He had it for a moment, but a great defensive play to jar it loose. Incomplete. Couldn't connect with Jordan Addison. So it'll be second down. Here's McCarthy to throw. A lot of guys there, and it's intercepted. Foyer Onulukin with the pick. And the Jaguars take over as he records his 10th career INT. Well, no doubt there was some doom and gloom on the sideline following their interception, right? But a little bit of new life now as their defense picks them up, gets it right back for them.
Hey, I am all for a nice little game of one-upmanship between these two defenses. You picked our guy off, fine. We'll answer right away. See how you follow that up.
He'll dump this one off to his running back, complete. And this is marked down right along that 40-yard line. That's 16 on the pickup. And that's a Jaguar first down.
Year after year, the best offenses are multifaceted. It's not just the receivers or the tight ends that can make plays through the air. When you get running backs that can attack the middle of the field like that, man, is it difficult on the defense.
Couldn't find Brian Thomas Jr. on that throw. So it's second down coming up.
That is a DB's best friend's pressure. That pressure earned that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target and hit him to alter that last second attempt to get rid of it.
Couldn't connect on first. It's second down. Out of the gun, Lawrence. Diving, it looks close. They say he caught it. Give him 11 yards, Brock, and a fresh set of downs. All right, all set up now. First and 10. Sticking in the air with Lawrence. He's on the move. And he just hucks this one away. Wasn't going to risk a throw or force something. It brings up second down.
He did exactly what he was supposed to do on that play. Felt the pressure and escapes the pocket. After that, it's on somebody downfield to get open and give him a target. No one did. And he simply has to get rid of it.
Lawrence trying again on second. Here's pressure, and he's dropped by the Vikings. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up.
Some guys, you just have to account for them, especially middle linebackers. I remember Ray Lewis, Brian Urlacher, it just felt like their presence took up the entire field. And this linebacker today, well, he had the interception earlier, a sack right now. You've got to start figuring out a plan for him, or he will take over this game.
He has the first over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 16. Third and 18 kills most drives, right? But they find an opening and hit it to pick up the first. Lawrence working from the gun. Has it in close. And they're going to get this down to the 4 before being stopped. It's a real solid pickup, 12 yards, and it rewards him with a first and goal. They'll run, ETN. And he pushed for it, but they managed to stop him at the 2. We're at the 2-minute warning now from Everbank. And it's the Jaguars, who only need a couple on 2nd and 2.
11, Agate. Rip, 23. Here we go, sir.
One more time with ETN. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. The Jaguars get some late points and the lead. Travis Etienne, the touchdown. That one splits the uprights. And they add one on to their first touchdown of the contest. Now is Cook to kick this away. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. They're out and set. First and 10. Trying it right side with Chandler. And he found some running room for a nice game. Vikings out of the hurry up. Need everyone back to the line. From the 38. Flush down out to his left. He gets this one to Chandler. And he stopped cold at the spots. Ooh, he paid for that one. But hey, still enough for that first down. McCarthy to throw it. He lets one fly deep downfield. Oh, brother, it's another interception. Picked off by Andre Sisco. And he's going to go. It's a pick six. On his little for the extra point. One right down the middle, and they'll continue adding to their lead. Well, Brock, hopefully some short memories on offense as they get it right back here on the kickoff after that pick six. So new kickoff rules, this is going to come out to the 30, not the 25 on the touchback. They'll get this drive started, first and 10. Now a give to Chandler, running right. And he found some running room for a nice game. Good run, gets him 7. That brings up 2nd and 3. From the 37. Launches one deep downfield. Really pushing the envelope on 2nd down, but the deep shot doesn't work.
You know, as a QB, I'm going to note that in the back of my head. That was a heck of a break. Knocks the ball away. DBs like that, they tend to, once they get one hand on the ball, have a pretty good bead on you and can get two hands on it the next time.
And he's tackled with the first down yardage. Back to throw. Here's McCarthy. And they pick him off again. Picked off by Andre Sisco. And the Jaguars take possession as he makes his 4th interception of our season. Oh, man, Brock. Somebody, those other leaders on that sideline, they've got to sit him down and calm him down. 3 consecutive drives now where he's thrown an interception.
Yeah, this defense is just all over him. Seeing every throw, anticipating these routes before they're even run. When he's dropping back to throw, and I know this feeling, it's horrible as a quarterback. It feels like there's 20 defenders out there on this defense.
Honey Thomas near the sideline. And he's out of bounds after reaching the 25-yard line. It's a 24-yard gash, and it gives them the first down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his right. And he maybe got back to the line there, but no further. The Jaguars are going to call their first timeout. They'll have 2 left to work with before halftime.
You know, sometimes, Kate, that pocket could be a lonely place. You're searching and searching for an escape valve, and there's none to be had. That time, nowhere to go. Run. And he was lucky to get back to the line before the defense swarmed him.
Someone stepped in. It's intercepted. Picked up by Stephon Gilmore. And the Vikings get the football back with minimal time to go in our half.
And what a huge bonus on top of the takeaway. Not only did you steal the possession, but you immediately, Kate, flip this field and give your teammates a golden opportunity to punch it in for 6. And if they score quickly, well, it'll put that opposing offense right back out there still reeling from that interception.
Here's McCarthy, 1st and 10. And oh, he got it! Interception! Jaguars are stopped on that return. So that interception is going to be the final play of this opening half. So we're halfway through this contest from Jacksonville. The hometown Jaguars out in front. Now we'll keep it in-state, but send you a couple hours away to our buddy in Orlando. It's Jonathan Coachman. He's got our EA Sports Halftime Report. Thanks so much for the look around the league, Coach. But now it's time to turn our attention back to this one as we begin the third quarter. Right, ready to send this one away. Here's a return from the 7. And he gets across the 30 before he's brought down.
Hey, you go into halftime with a double-digit lead, your number one objective, and they'll all say it in that locker room, it's 0-0 to begin the second half. So you want to come out firing the same way you did in that first half. And that kick returner, he took matters in his own hands.
First and 10, it's Lawrence. That one is caught left side of the field. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. They get 28 out of that play. And that'll be good for a Jacksonville first down. They'll try it left with Etienne. And there was really nowhere to go there. Just a small push to the 37. Give him a few yards on that run. It's 2nd and 7.
Okay, that's a run that's ho-hum on the stat sheet. But if you see a bigger play on the ground later on, it'll largely be because of a play just like that one. Softening up the front and opening the door for a bigger gap in the future.
Here's 2nd and 7. Catch is made down the right sideline. And this play reaches the 12-yard line before the stop is made. Offense set for a 1st and 10. From the red zone now. Escapes out to the left. Play didn't break how they wanted it, and he throws this away.
Look at the coverage on that play, Kate. I love that. That is textbook defense right there. When the quarterback escapes the pocket, man, you got to find somebody. You got to go get sticky on your offensive guy. That's exactly what the secondary did, and it forces the throwaway.
And he will score. Touchdown, Jacksonville. The Jaguars grow the lead coming out of halftime. It's a Christian Kirk touchdown. That one splits the uprights. And they'll continue adding to their lead. On now is Cook to kick this away. It's Brandon Powell with the return. He's got a lane up past the 30. And a good return here as he gets it out past the 35. So good field position to start with for the Vikings this drive, 1st and 10. They'll try it left with Chandler. And he'll go down, and we'll say right at the 39-yard line. It's a gain of 3 for him. That brings up 2nd and 7. From the 39. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free. Incomplete. Last pass unsuccessful, and they have 3rd down here. McCarthy looking to throw. He's trying to push the field. Well, they had the look. Certainly didn't shy away from it, but couldn't connect. And now they're stuck facing 4th down. Minnesota lined up in punt formation. And this somehow is only going to be our first punt of the game. Only needed once last week in the win, and he matches that total here. And a big hit on the return to stop it cold. So no return on that punt. And it'll be Jaguars football. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10.
Hey, easy. Ralph.
From the gun, Etienne gets it. And he found some running room for a nice gain. Call it 9 yards. Looked like a first for a moment. It's 2nd and 1.
Hey,
So much to like about that run, Kate, particularly what he was able to get out of it. The defense, I think, feels a little fortunate they were able to track him down before an even bigger run and crossing that first down marker.
And he stopped cold at the spots. Ooh, he paid for that one, but hey, still enough for that first down.
May not be the way he typically gets the ball, Kate, but once he had it in his hands like a reception, he knew what to do with it. He smelled that first down, and he went and got it.
Rolling left, behind some Oh, he was on the move, but so was the defense, and they take him down. And the big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
Hey, hey, go, go. Go, go, let's go. Silver.
Trying again, following the sack. And they get there to touch him down, Brock, but a big gain on that play.
Well, that one was drawn up and delivered beautifully, efficiently. If it's not circled on the call sheet already, you better believe it is now.
Okay, ready.
Let's see what they draw up on these third and
11,
seven.
11.
From the shotgun, Lawrence. And it's incomplete, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
I mean, you could see it right there. The trajectory of the ball changed as it was in flight. You know, on shorter throws, receivers, they could focus, they can adjust quickly. But on a long-distance throw like that, a tip, well, it really alters the course of the ball and makes it so tough to make an adjustment in time.
And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. And after the punch, the offense comes out onto the field. And it's going to be Vikings football. New slate of downs to approach here from the 40. First and 10, here's McCarthy. Oh no, they get him yet again! Picked off by Xavier Howard! And the Jaguars get the football as he makes his third interception of this season.
You know, my dad was my old high school coach. He's a play caller, he's an offensive guy. And after days like this, and I remember one in particular, he'd say, "Son, some days peanuts, some days shells." This has been nothing but a bunch of shells for this quarterback today.
Here we go.
Davis there to grab it. He has room past the 25. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. He picks up 28 on the play. And that's a Jaguar first down. Working inside the red zone. And the Vikings rush brings him down.
Even from the booth, Kate, I could hear it. I could hear that front seven telling the guys on the back end, "Hey, all I need is a couple seconds of lockdown from you guys, and I'm going to get to this QB.
Hey,
you promise that you deliver?" And that's exactly what they did, wasted no time in getting that sack.
The throw is caught. And he will score. Touchdown, Jacksonville. The Jaguars lengthen the lead at the end of the third. Honest Little for the extra point. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. On now is Cook to kick this away. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. And the drive will start out with a first and 10. Trying down the middle with Chandler. And he's down after getting this up to the 41. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And it'll bring up a Minnesota first down. They'll stick with Chandler. What a hit! He gets flattened to the ground. He managed 6 on the play, bringing up 2nd and 4.
Come back,
Now a give. It's Chandler headed left. And he's got a chunk of yards as we've reached the end of three. Thankfully, only one quarter to play now. We've reached the end of three in this lopsided affair. The Vikings have it to start the fourth, and given that score, they're going to need points every time out from here on. From the 44-yard line now, first and 10. The Jaguars are going to call their first timeout. May still have two to work with in this final quarter. From the 44-yard line now, first and 10.
Let's go!
From the shotgun, McCarthy. Able to find Chandler here. And he works this to the 38 before going down.
That is the epitome of staying on schedule. That kind of completion right there on first down. Well, it opens up the entirety of the playbook for second down. A third and short in your back pocket, you can get even more aggressive and take that shot.
Taking a big shot for the end. And the defender comes away with it. Picked off by Tyson Campbell. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10.
Let's go.
Lawrence in the pistol. Short pass caught by his tight end. Makes the 15. And he will score. Touchdown, Jacksonville. The Jaguars keep running away with this. It's a Christian Kirk touchdown. On his little for the extra point. That one splits the uprights. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Is Cook to kick this away. His return starts at the 5. His return gets him to the 32-yard line before he's taken down. They're out and set, first and 10. Interception last drive doesn't deter them. They're going right back to the air. He's out in the clear. And the Jaguars get the football as he makes his third interception of this season.
Intercepted. The Jaguars take over first and 10 at the 36-yard line.
First down, ball at the 36.
On red.
Right up the gut. And he won't salvage that. It's a loss on the play.
Hey, look, in the right situation, you catch a team off guard. Well, this could be a tremendous play for some big yards. But in the wrong situation, you get hit in the mouth right behind the line of scrimmage.
Back to the line they go. It's second down. Taps it quick to the receiver coming across. And not a lot of room for him as he's brought down. Give him 3 on that run. 3rd and 12 coming up.
This is one of those real modest gains, Kate, that I like as a call. And it's just a little more variety to your playbook. Makes that defense wonder. Those guys on the other side of the ball think a little bit. This dude's not just a receiver. He may get in the run game as well.
And he's out of bounds just inside the red zone. That play goes for 19 and a new set of downs.
This dude's just simply got a nose for the marker no matter how they get him the ball. Kate, hand it to him, and he sniffs out that first down. Get it to him on a screen, and it's no different. He surges ahead and keeps this drive moving.
And he's able to push this down to the 12. It's a solid 7-yard pickup on first down. Now they're going to have second and three.
23.
Brings up second and three.
Silver.
Out of the gun, a give to ETN. And he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away.
An offensive group really hoped he was going to get it all right there, reset it back to first down. But instead, the defense, well, they're not going to let anything come easy. And their fight is giving them a chance to stall things out on third and short.
Quickly looking left, and it's complete. And he will score. Touchdown, Jacksonville. The Jaguars throwing six more on the blowout. Brian Thomas Jr., the touchdown. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. On now is Cook to kick this away. Returning in from the 16. And in the end, Brock, an exciting touchback as the return comes out to the 30.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
They'll get this drive started. First and 10.
Let's go now.
Looking to throw here and shake off that previous INT. Throwing quickly, but it's incomplete. Looking for the back that time. So second down coming up.
That just goes to show you can't take any completion for granted, even on some of the shortest passes in the game plan.
19,
McCarthy trying again on second down. He fires one deep down the middle. He's got it inside the 25. It's a huge pickup on the play. And that's going to give the Vikings the first down. Now they'll hit the line just outside the red zone following that big play. Now Chandler. And he'll scurry forward for a pickup of three.
You know, not a ton of yards, but still showing that commitment to the ground game. The type of run that keeps the defense from loading up in coverage and focusing entirely on that passing game.
He brings it in. And they get this down to the 7-yard line. It's the 2-minute warning here in Jacksonville. Vikings hoping to do some window dressing in the time remaining. This offense in position now. It's first and goal. Operating from the gun, it's McCarthy. Buys time, rolling right. And it won't matter in the end, but nevertheless, he's in for the late touchdown. The Vikings putting up points in a game decided. Vikings electing not to kick it. The offense staying out there. They're going for two. They'll try to run it in. And he's going to get in for 2 points, which, well, it doesn't do a ton to help on the scoreboard right now, partner, but a positive moment at the very least. And this is covered by the Jaguars. And he works this to the 38 before going down. Well, I guess they kind of had to do it here, Brock.
Yeah, it's called a have to. Yeah, kind of have to at this point of the game, huh?
Okay, but like most things in this game, it did not work out for them.
Yeah, let's face it. Even if they do recover that, probably not going to find a way to win. But this is a time where you work on things, where you do build to the following week. Got to find a way to flush this because it's just not been their kind of game.
3 yards on the first down play, and that brings up second and 7. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
I think with that call, they were trying to set him up with a short third down run, but he said, Nope, not on my watch. I'll just go get it all right here. Now, playbook's wide open for first and 10.
Has some space inside the 15. And stop me if you've heard this before, Brock. They've scored again, and they grow that lead further. Jaguars continue adding to an insurmountable lead. Travis Etienne, the touchdown. The extra point is up, and it is good. And they'll continue adding to their lead. On now is Cook to kick this away. Short kick here, fielded at the 15. They'll have decent field position to begin with here. Brockies tackled just beyond that 30-yard line. They've got first down from the 31. From the shotgun, McCarthy. Well, the pressure nearly got to him, but still a good play defensively as that one falls incomplete. So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Now it's McCarthy. A bit of desperation on this deep shot. Had the window to go deep, but just couldn't make it happen. Now it's third down.
I think it's fair to say, in the eye in the sky didn't lie, without that ball being tipped, we were looking at the big game. A missed opportunity to push their offense and a great play on the other side to deny the throw.
That is caught downfield on the right side. And he's going to get stopped right around the 45-yard line. So the Jaguars come away with the win in this one. I came in the-